to get some feedback. Full-time traders and for those who are part-time traders. And, you know, surprisingly, there are so many people who were voting that they were full-time traders. You know, that is very encouraging for so many people who are traders. Yeah, it's good to know that so many people who are full-time traders. Now, after seeing that, you know, the group has so many people. There are so many people in the group. There are now more than 500 people on the group, which is very encouraging. It's very good to know that there are so many traders out there. Yeah, and I have a lot of respect for everyone who is on the group, because trading is not something that you simply just get into. You know, putting aside all the difficulties that are within within the whole activity of trading, there is the whole bias, you know, that comes with it. There's too much bias everywhere that, you know, if you're going into trading, you know, you'd rather do this and that and that. There's too much bias, and so many people will try to stop you from entering these financial markets for good reason, because of the risks involved. And I think after doing some studies and after getting some good information about the market, so the real risk is basically with the traders. It's not with the market itself. The market can present a risk, but it is us who really make that risk very big. Yeah, so after looking at all the activities on the, you know, within this on the group, within all these people who are posting things, you know, there is a hunger. You know, there is a very big hunger to make a lot of money. You know, people are hungry to make money, and it's not bad. It's not bad to want something that badly, but how you make that money really, really matters. You shouldn't just rush into something and expect to make so much in a very short period of time. It's very, very bad. And there are so many demo accounts in the group. You know, I've spoken against them in the past, but the people who keep on posting them, they are very, very resilient. I don't want to stop anyone from doing anything. I just hope that people will become more responsible and, you know, become civilized and stop doing these childish things. Posting a demo accounts of $100,000, making a very big amount of money from one peep, yeah, with a big lot. You know, you make with a very big lot size, you have a lot size of about 10.0, then you have about 10 trades with that 10.0, you just make one pip per trade, and that gives you like $100 on each trade. 10.0 lot size, and then you make one pip, and then the new people in the group, they start jumping that, hey, you know, these are the possibilities, this is what. But that is very discouraging, and it's very, very irresponsible. It's extremely irresponsible. And yeah, so if you're on the group and you're doing that sort of thing, you know, just stop it. It's really not helping anyone, and it's not helping you at all. So just, you know, get a sizable account, and you know, if you want to show people how good you are, it's okay. You know, I'm not going to stop anyone from doing any of that. If you want to show people how good you are, then get a real account, put on a sizable amount of money, and put it there. You know, you might not even have trades every day. You might not even take those risks that you take on that demo. When you might not take those risks on a real account, even if you're willing to lose that money, that responsibility will kick in. So, so for those who are on the group, I think you join the group and you see so many posts about so many things. All these guys are posting their things, you know, dancing around and, yeah, showing those accounts with very big amounts of money. Yeah, don't be swayed by such things. You know, now that, okay, we're still in the beginning stages of moving as a community. You know, there are some other bad things happening in the past. There were some guys who were, you know, very, very proud and arrogant and ignorant as well. Very ignorant and posting things about how they can, make your account, you can get your $10 and turn it into $150 in a short period of time, and you know, all that stuff. Eh? So, yeah, though it's not impossible, but you know, it's a bit irresponsible to do things of that nature at that scale. Eh? It's really, really irresponsible, and the results were really not good. Eh? No, for those people, the results were not really bad for them because they don't lose. Eh? It is the people who they contact who lose. Eh? So there are many promises to make a lot of money, and the best thing to do about it, the best way to go about such things is by going through maybe a really proven method that you can really bank on if you want to make money. But the ultimate goal of the group is for everyone to be an independent trader, and that is the goal. That is the real goal, because there's nothing better than that. If you're an independent trader and you can make decisions on your own and you can risk your own money and know what to do at a particular time, then that is real success. That is real success. Better than someone taking your money and blowing it and whatever. You know, it happens a lot. It happens a lot, and it's not good. It's not good to lose money like that. So you have to be very careful with how you're going to deal with your money. You know, if you don't trust yourself with your money, then you know, build that trust until you're able to trust yourself, then you can invest the money. Because anyone who presents any kind of solution to you is going to take that money from you, and they might either take it for themselves or they might risk it and lose it, and you know, there won't be anyone to blame there. So be very careful on how you handle your money, and you know, do everything that is possible to trust yourself. You know, trust yourself with your own money. Do not make unreasonable risks. So yesterday I talked about that app, the technical analysis app. There was some good feedback. Some people called me throughout the night. They were looking for that app on the website and wherever. So yeah, that was very good. That was very good response. I realized that I'd taken a long time without using it on the program. So I'm going to use it again today. We shall look for some charts that are trending according to the app. And yeah, we shall find some charts and see where they are headed and see how to get some trades out of them. So that was very good response. And I really hope you will use that app. First, use it on your demo account. Look for some charts that are trending. Then look for points where they could really look for that demand zone and that supply zone and see how far that chart can go. Then you can trade using that app. It will show you how every time frame is trending, and you can make an informed decision using it. It's not really bad, and it's not really hard to use. And the information is there in real time. It's not... doesn't show you the market of maybe a few hours ago, whatever. Those charts are there in real time, all those time frames. So it's very, very useful. It's a tool that you can use whichever way you want. I can't really tell you that only use it to work with it in this way or the other way. You know, just make sure you study it first, basing on your own understanding of the market, and see how it can come in handy when you're trading. If you can't use it, then you can leave it alone. If you can't use it, just leave it alone. The frequency of trades per day, sometimes you may not get so many trades. You know, my manual trading methods, there are very few trades that I can really give you per day or per week. If I don't see a trade in a chart, I leave it. Even if the chart is moving, I just don't I don't mess with it. So my methods might not be what you would look at a get rich quick way of making money. My methods are a bit very moderate. I don't trade all the time. I don't trade every day all the time. I look for some really good entry points that I'm very comfortable with. Then I will take that decision. That's how I trade manually. And that's how, that is a normal way of trading manually anyway. Scalping is a whole other thing. So I can't give you scalping trades because scalping is very risky. So if you're trading if you're very responsible and you trade in a very responsible way, you might not have many trades in a day. You might not have many entry points, but even when you look through the charts with your own eyes, you will get tired. If you're looking at maybe 50 charts, you will get tired, and maybe the 25th chart, you will just be very exhausted, and maybe you will start searching again a bit later on. So where my many trades come in is with the robots. So the robots, they do the hunting for me in most cases. They go and they search throughout all the other charts and they find those entry points which I can't really define by looking at the market. You know, there's a very careful process that I really go through to put an entry point into the robot and adjusting and testing. So by the time it gets in there, it's not really something I can see on a chart and say that, you know what, that is some entry point that I put in some robot. It's really, you know, the robots are a bit more complex, but when I'm trading manually, you know, I look for, you know, simple things that your mind can really relate to, things that, you know, like, you know, all the kinds of trading of price action and whatever, these Fibonacci retracements, you know, all those simple things which your mind can see very fast. If you don't see it on one chart, you keep on moving to the next and changing different time frames. So by the time you reach, if you reach about 20 charts, and you're looking at four time frames, maybe the 15-minute chart has the smallest, 30 minutes, then 1 hour and 4 hour charts. If you look at four of those time frames on every chart, and you have about, let's say, 25 charts that you've so far looked at, you've looked at about 100 charts in collection, and that is that can be very stressful to your mind. So yeah, that's why I put robots to do all those other things. So robots, I can make a robot very risky, or I can reduce its risk, and you know, it will have many entry points because, you know, it's a robot, it does what robots do. But as a human being, you can't have so many entry points all the time, and yeah, as a human being, you can't just you can't just wake up one moment and you get an entry point just like that. You know, it's possible. Yeah, it could happen. Nothing is really impossible, but that is not something that happens all the time. So if you put yourself on that pressure, you know, to trade every single time you look at the charts, you're going to end up taking some decisions that you really shouldn't have taken, and it will be very bad for you. So the Telegram group has there are now more than 500 people, and you know, it's now quite big, and yeah, so there are big plans for the group, and yeah, and you know, this, you know, with Forex you have to be very careful with everything that you do, especially when you're in groups. You know, if you lose money as a group, it's very bad. You know, you collectively lose a lot of money. Yeah, but if you make money as a group, you make a lot of money. So the plans that are there for the group, they are collective plans. We should all move. We should all move together. You know, we should all move at the same pace. You know, together, those who have a lot, maybe we'll earn a lot. Those who have little, we'll earn little. But you know, we should all move step by step. So that I was talking about some New Year resolutions. Obviously, you know, it's something within every human. It's like imprinted in every human's brain. Every time the year is beginning, you want to have some New Year resolutions. You want to start planning that, you know, this year I'm not going to risk this big, I'm not going to risk a big percentage of my account. I'm going to be very responsible with my trades and whatever. So people make all sorts of resolutions. You know, people who drive say, I want to drive past this speed limit. People who drink a lot of alcohol, they don't say, I want to drink this much alcohol. They just say, I won't spend this much on alcohol. But if the bottles come, I will drink those ones. But I won't spend, I won't waste money. I won't spend a lot of money buying bottles. But if they come, I will take. So the limit, you know, you always make a new resolution that I will limit myself in this way and that way and that way. So as a community of traders, you know, there are also some New Year resolutions that will be there. And you know, it's good to prepare. Yeah, to prepare as early as now. That's why I was asking people, are you a full-time trader or are you a part-time trader? Yeah, if you're a full-time trader, then you know you understand what it means to do things long-term. Eh? You know, to have a whole half a year to, you know, doing something and seeing how far you will go in that half a year. I posted that video about the Gold Rush robot to show you how just, you know, one year can go with a robot, how, you know, how profitable it can be. So the Gold Rush, it uses, this minimum account is, you know, very, very big. You need like $5,000. But, you know, if we have, there are many systems in Forex where so many accounts can be traded from one account. So without having the robot, you know, the Gold Rush can really trade for you. If you come together and we make up this amount of money as a group, yeah, I think for 500 people, you need about $10 each to reach 5K. Yeah, then, you know, that, then on separate accounts, then through some kind of metric system, all these accounts are brought together to form that minimum account. Then the Gold Rush can trade it for 1 year. So for one whole year, you can just forget about it. You just turn away and the robot will do its work. You know, because if 500 people use 500 computers to trade their single accounts, yeah, those are, that's a lot of resources. And many people don't even have computers. They just have phones. So if we collect all the accounts into one metric system and then put that under one computer, then everyone can benefit in very many ways. So in addition to the Gold Rush, there are many other robots. I think there are many robots that I'm working on, robots that can trade for a whole year. You know, they have to pass that test of time, of trading for a whole year. Now, I understand that many people don't really understand robots. And by all means, if you don't understand something, do not even bother attempting to do it. You know, just leave it alone. You know, just, you know, like Africans, they don't go to the moon because they don't understand those things very well. But the people who understand, they go there. Yeah? They go there and they come back. Others are planning to go to Mars and maybe they will come back. But those who don't understand such things, you don't really bother yourself with planning to go to the moon. I don't know if there's any plan here in Africa for people to go to the moon. You know, we have bigger, you know, we have bigger problems. We have to work on our agriculture and what, you know, all that stuff. So planning to go to the moon could really be, you know, it's something out of the bounds of our thinking. So if you don't understand something, or if it doesn't make sense to you, then, you know, by all means, do not attempt it. You know, don't do something that you really don't understand, something you don't really believe in. And yeah, so for robots, you know, you might be a trader. Being a trader alone is difficult because many people will really try to pull you down from being a trader. Now, a trader who does robots, that is something else. That is now another level. So before you make that other leap, you know, just don't, you know, don't, you know, okay, I make robots, and it might seem like I'm sort of discouraging you from using them, but, you know, I still don't want to convince anyone. You know, convincing is a really bad thing. Convincing someone to do something is not good. It's like using some false information to achieve certain goals. But instead of convincing, I'd really appreciate it if people read about them and experienced them. And, you know, by the time you experience a robot, you have to experience what it means to be a manual trader. You know, if you're not at that level of being able to trade for yourself in a very responsible way, then, you know, you might not be able to make that next step. It's not something simple. You have to be a trader already in order to start using robots. So that is something else altogether. So it will be very good if, one, you gain the skills to be a manual trader, then you actually trade. You experience what it feels like to make money. You experience what it's like to lose money, to go through the, you know, the emotional stress of losing money, then that happiness of making some money, and also experience making money and believing that this is not enough. You know, you have $100, your account makes $30, and you feel like $30 is very little money for me. It's very little. I want more. Then you lose that 30. So that experience is also very, very important. Undermining profits. It's bad to undermine profits, especially when they are good profits. So you have to experience all those things. And also analyze and be consistent in your trading. So once you've experienced that, then you can take the next step to go into automated systems. Then you will understand what happens there. You will appreciate what happens there, because from a point where you're not informed, you know, it might seem like this is trial and error. This is, you know, it will be very risky for you. So I don't want to discourage anyone from going for that, or to discourage anyone from trading Forex, but you know, there are systems in everything, and you have to understand how all these things work. The end goal is obviously to make some money, but between you depositing money and withdrawing money, there is a whole activity that has to take place in between, and that's where your attention should be. How it works, how does this work? Do not be ignorant of that process, because that is what matters. It's like walking into a hospital sick and coming out when you're okay. What happens in between there really matters a lot. It's very important that you understand what happens in between that beginning point and that end point. So if you don't understand what happens in between there, then you shouldn't have expectations of that end point. You know, you shouldn't just expect money out of Forex when you haven't put any attention of what happens in between. If you don't appreciate the process, if you don't really understand the process, if you don't have the information that you need to understand the process, then do not expect that, and you know, that money that comes at the end of it to come to you so easily from wherever. You have to really understand what happens. That's why we go to school, to understand things. You know, we go to school to understand to understand whatever is happening around us. That's why we go to school, to know why is this happening. We understand history, that this happened in history and it's repeating itself. That happened because A, B, C, D. Some woman told people to buy bread, to buy cakes instead of bread and whatever. And you know, when you repeat the same thing, you get problems. So you learn all that stuff from the past so that you know how to handle better your future. You become wiser. So studying really helps. Education really helps. So educate yourselves, or look for someone to look for the most satisfying way to study whatever you're going to study. If it is Forex, you know, if it's YouTube, then you know, go to YouTube and study from there, as long as it is satisfying. If it is PDFs, you know, get those PDFs and read them. If it's audiobooks, get those audiobooks. You know, whatever it takes to learn, whatever process leads you to learning something, take that process and learn. But you know, at the end of it all, make sure you have learned and you understand, so that we are adults. You know, we're not children, we're not babies. We can't start crying because we lost some money. You have to become wiser than that. You need to know why you lost that money, and you need to know how to avoid that in the future. That's what adulthood is. That's what being mature is. And in this Forex thing, you know, you really need to be mature, because you know, there is no room there is no room for errors. There is no room for playing the blame game. There is no room for any of that. It's rough. It's very rough, and it's rough on everyone every day. You know, when you're successful today, tomorrow is another day. You need to have another trade. You have to go through a very hectic process to get another trade. So there is no rest. There is no rest for anyone. You have to really be, you have to be on point all the time. You have to put behind all those things that make you very dependent, and you become very, very dependent on yourself. So study, and you know, put that emotional part away. Just understand why you failed and how you can avoid that in the future, and how you can profit in the future. So, yeah, so taking big risks, you know, really, if you're, you know, people in the Telegram group, if you're not part of it, you can join the group. It is Trading Dawn. You can search for Trading Dawn on Telegram. That's the name of this program, Trading Dawn. Search for it, or search for BVB Trade FX, and you'll get to that Telegram group. Yeah, so try as much as try as much as possible to discourage people who are putting those demos with big figures. You know, it's really okay. It is misleading for so many people. It might be a good boost for those who are posting them. They might really need that kind of you know, whatever feelings they get from posting these things. But if you post you know, real and moderate accounts and real trades, then it might be, you know, it's going to be rough. It's going to be very rough in the beginning, but you know, it will be better than the whole fantasy world. So it's going to be very rough, and I'm really encouraging it so that people really grow, yeah, on the group, so that people start growing out of all these demos with big numbers and really, really start growing. You know, it's very important to grow. It's not an easy process. Forex is not easy. It's what we are doing is not easy at all. This is very, very difficult stuff. But you know, we must approach it with a mature approach. So let us get no more accounts and start posting those pictures. And so when the account grows, you benefit. You don't benefit anything from a demo of $100,000. You don't benefit anything. And the people who see it might also put big lots on their accounts, and they might lose money. So there will be a lot of loss taking place. So let's try to be as moderate as possible. Let us trade when we actually see trades on the market, so that we profit like that. So the accounts might grow slowly, but I can assure you it will be very, very better for everyone if the accounts posted there are moderate accounts with simple amounts of money, which everyone can afford. And you know, from there we start growing. You know, we start growing slowly. It was like that in the beginning. People were posting their accounts. Other accounts were getting blown. You know, accounts of $5, accounts of $3, and they're getting blown. And people had started really giving advice, and things were moving well until these high risk maneuvers came in. High risk kinds of trading. Someone putting 20 trades in one trade. Multiplies it 20 times, and you know, all that sort of stuff. So if we keep on doing that, yeah, people are going to be misled. Naturally, people will be misled, and it doesn't help anyone. So you know, I really appreciate, maybe for the remainder of this week, you know, you can post your things. You can post your pictures with those big accounts, and then you put those memes afterwards, those gifs of people dancing with money. You know, those things that have been on the group, you can do that for the remainder of the week. But starting on Monday, if you know, if you can start, if you can have that self-control to start today, that will be very good for everyone. You know, we are all in this together. So, you know, this is for everyone's benefit. So if you do that, then, you know, we shall start seeing those real accounts, and you can advise someone accordingly, knowing whatever they are doing. But if you see demo accounts that are making $20,000 on a daily basis, and you start seeing all those things, they may not really help someone, or $15 or $20. It will be very bad for campuses. You know, campuses don't have a lot of money to invest $20,000. You know, it's really misleading. It's really misleading for those guys. They are really there are many responsible people in the group, but these small, you know, these small characters are really misleading things. And you know, it's I haven't blocked anyone from the group, but you know, the group itself has been filtering out bad characters. So for the growth of everyone, let us take this, you know, let us be very responsible and start trading real accounts, however small they are, and we post those results, and you know, we shall grow out of you know, bad trades, from making bad trades to becoming profitable traders. You know, maybe it will take a month or two or three. Yeah, it will be rough and difficult, but you know, that's the beauty of it all. These rough days are the ones that really give you that foundation of, you know, when you reach somewhere far, you know, you will look back where you came from, and you will really appreciate that journey that you took. Yeah, the heartaches, the disappointments, depressions, the, you know, all those things that will happen. You will look back and you know where you're coming from, and you'll be a better trader in the future. Yeah. So, yeah, so for the app, download the app from the BVB Trade FX, BVB Trade FX website. You can get the app. Now, everything there is free. There are two robots there. There is Inception. There is Titan Trust. Titan Thrust. You can download those robots. Everything on the website is free. You just browse through the website and get whatever you want. I'm going to change it very soon. So some things may not be there. But right now, what is there, browse through it and download whatever you want. Everything is free. Study it and see how it can help you. And, we shall get better like that. So thank you for watching. I really hope you'll have a good day today. I hope your trades will be very profitable. If you're in bad trades, then hang in there. We shall find ways of rectifying that. If you're not part of the Telegram group, it's BVB Trade FX. You can search for that, or you can search for Trading Dawn, the name of this group, and you will get there. And we shall see how to progress from where we are to where we want to be. So thank you for watching. Have a good day. Goodbye.